Aloha. Isn't that a great word? Aloha, that means love. And that's why we're here, because of the love that we have for our Lord. And that's why you're here, I know for sure. We're having today taped as a memorial for somebody that we will be talking about. But in the meantime, I wanted to start off the service as we always do every single week. We've been here for 6 years today. I know. And we taped that song, all those songs as a background music for the opening and then for the closing, of course. And so I figured how appropriate that we should have that and then discuss the entertainer that is actually entertaining us with the background music. Hi. So what we're going to do is we're going to do what we always do, what we started 6 years ago today, by reading from our wonderful Bible. So if you happen to have it with you, open up to Psalms 100 and we'll get started, all right? It says, it's a psalm of thanksgiving, by the way. A shout, shout with joy to the Lord, O earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him singing with joy. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. He made us and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. So let us enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Let us go into his courts with praise. Let us give thanks to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His unfailing love continues forever, and his faithfulness continues to each generation. So will you join me now as we open in prayer? Heavenly Father, first off, we want to just say thank you, thank you, thank you. We want to start off this service with an attitude of gratitude, that this being our sixth anniversary to have this church service, us living ministry here at the Chapel by the Sea. How special is that? We say thank you, Heavenly Father, for all the blessings that you have bestowed upon this ministry and the people that have walked through this wonderful pavilion and gone home, came back. So wonderful. So today, once again, we join together collectively. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to bless us. Bless this body of Christ. Bless us with this person sitting beside us. But speak to us also intimately and privately and quietly, that we will be able to walk out of here knowing without a shadow of a doubt that we truly have been touched by the hand of God. And we say thank you for that. This truly is the day that you have made, and we will rejoice in it. And all of God's children in agreement said, amen. Amen. All right, get out your song sheets. Here we go. This is the time that I really thoroughly enjoy. I started the services just around 22 years ago, 21 years ago. We'll talk about it today. And one of the things that I was over at the Sheridan originally, and then I went over to the Lahui Okalani Congregational Church, and I was there for 7 years, and it was wonderful because when I went through my church classes and ministry classes and all the kind of classes that you're supposed to take, anyway, they never taught that this part about do a prayer part for the congregation. And yet I know that a lot of the churches do that, yeah? But I had never been taught that. So when I went over to the Lahui Okalani Congregational Church, and that was one of the things that the Hawaiian Church did there, it was founded in 1850, and it was a non-denominational Christian church service like this one. I was the first woman there. I was the first Howley there, the first Caucasian. I used to tell the people when they would show up, I knew they were surprised to see, first off, a lady, and then a Caucasian lady. So I used to tell them, would you believe that I'm an albino Hawaiian? They liked that. They liked that, just like you laughed, you know. But one of the things they did over there that I really loved and adopted for our own ministry here at the Living Ministry is they had a prayer request time. Now, it became very obvious to me that I was very shallow in interacting with people because I found them to be marvelously happy when they would go on honeymoons or vacation or whatever. And I wasn't able to really dig into their hearts, and they didn't let me see. And I obviously was so shallow, I didn't think to ask. But there were tears in those hearts that I was, a lot of the people that I was interfacing with. A lot of the people that would travel on to this island, would be their last wish. David was here, Candace was here, you guys were here when that young girl, we're talking 11-year-old girl that was passing away. She had had a bone marrow transplant and it didn't work. She had a second one, didn't work, and this was it. So the Make-A-Wish Foundation came forward, said, "What do you want, little one?" She said, "I want to go surfing in Maui." So she showed up. She was in the back of the room. We were able to pray with her. My point is that it looked like a wonderful mother and two girls on a vacation, but what it was a place filled with tears. So I thought, wow, what a great opportunity to be standing in front of people to kind of get us together, to remind us of what the Bible says. It's our Heavenly Father that told us. He sent His Son, and His Son said, if two of you, now listen up now, you guys, He says, if two of you would agree upon anything, if you ask that in My name, not in somebody else's name, but in My name, said Jesus, My Father in heaven will give it to you. End of story. I found that mind-blowing, and I figured that everybody needed to hear that. The children, they pray for their little schoolmates. Often they want, I even have them ask for better grades. I love that. You know, sometimes it's not as serious as we think it is, but it is to them. Hello. So two or more gathered in His precious name. Now, does that mean that we'll always get what we want? Absolutely not. We're praying to the one that has all the answers. He knows everything. He knows before us, the future, behind what we're going through. He knows what's best. And if we're really trusting in Him, then we can honestly say, all right, I've given it to Him. He knows what I'd like. It may not be the right answer, though. It may not be the right timing. I might not even see it in this lifetime. Amen. But He heard it, and He'll answer it. End of story. So I figured, why not do this with people that are sitting together? Then they come together. Do you know how many people go on vacation from your church that don't end up at a church while they're on vacation? Think on that. So in the Bible, we're referred to as the saints. Doesn't make us better. It just means we attend church even on vacation. Amen. So what you're doing is you're sitting with people that have a tremendous love affair going on with the Heavenly Father. They already have a walking relationship with them. So if there's a concern in your heart, wouldn't it be cool to be praying next to this saint? Now, do we need to know what the prayer request is or what the whole story is? Absolutely not. In fact, if you tell me your story, I'll probably give you my 2 cents. And you don't need my 2 cents. You need the Lord's reply. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to hold up prayer requests right now, and we're going to come together, and then we'll have a wonderful event after.